Aloha, I'm Jill Baltimore, Executive Director of Teach for America Hawaii. Since 2006, Teach for America Hawaii has recruited, trained, and supported educators and advocates for Hawaii public schools. Guided by our values of kuleana, ohana, and aloha, we are committed to the vision that one day, all keiki will have excellent educational opportunities and life options. We partner with schools to support excellence in teaching and strive for our educators to inspire students to see themselves as leaders now and in the future. We are a local organization making a local impact. Nearly 250 of our recruits identify as kama'aina, and today we have 575 members living here in Hawaii. They are teaching in classrooms, leading schools, working at the DOE system level and in higher education. They are nonprofit leaders, policymakers, and healthcare professionals. Each is committed to cultivating a vibrant community for our keiki.
Isaiah Pule and Kenny Furencheck go way back. Pule was once a student at Kamaile Academy in Waianae. Furencheck, his teacher and mentor.
I didn't like him too much because he was a math teacher. I wasn't a math fan. The way I grew up, and school wasn't too important to me when I was in ninth grade. I was getting D's and F's in my classes, still getting sent to the front office.
It was a lot, and I don't think I was a very effective teacher early on.
But Furencheck's training as a Teach for America core member laid the groundwork for success, enabling him to overcome the challenges he faced in the classroom.
I think a lot of kids in our community had a lot of people leave their lives and a lot of inconsistency, and a big part of it was just showing up and just giving it your all every day, even though every lesson wasn't effective.
Furencheck is from a steel town in Ohio with a vastly different background from his students, yet he embraced his assignment on the Waianae coast.
I was just absolutely blessed to land in, I think, the best community on the planet.
And he found a way to connect with Pule and others through their culture.
It was easy for me with my students to just get excited about the culture because I was learning about it with them.
He took his students to the Marine Education Training Center in Sand Island once a week after school to work in dry dock with a hokulea and eala.
He wasn't my teacher, he was a co-learner. We were both learning of this culture. We were both learning of hokulea. Kenny's teaching me more about myself and my culture than anybody else ever did. How can somebody that looks so different from me, grew up so differently from me, and has like different perspective from me, teach me more about myself than I ever knew?
Pule, who is half Hawaiian and half Marshallese, remembers his difficult beginnings. Among his earliest memories was seeing his dad go to prison.
Through all of this, I've transitioned through multiple foster homes. My fifth foster home adopted me. Throughout all of these transitions, I wasn't grounded in family.
It wasn't until Pule was in middle school and high school that he found positive adult influences in his aunties, uncles, and teachers. And that changed the trajectory of his life.
Kenny was really the one who pushed education and the importance of education for me. So back in ninth grade, what made me value education was the canoe. What made me value education was my identity and my culture. He taught me about my passion. He taught me about my identity. He taught me more about my culture. And he taught me to just like really be invested in myself and who I am and where I come from. Talking to Kenny my senior year, trying to really navigate through all of this.
Pule graduated from Kamaile and went on to the University of Rochester in New York, where he earned degrees in film and business with a minor in computer science.
He told me that I'm the pebble and Waianae is my pond. The world is the ocean. Focus on your pond first and make your impact there. I knew that if I wanted to come back home, I wanted to reground myself and be purposeful in the work that I wanted to do, TFA was my best route to go.
So Pule returned to Waianae and his alma mater to follow in his teacher's footsteps as a Teach for America core member, teaching, of all things, math.
What I really love is that TFA just doesn't provide the bodies, but they provide the structural and cultural support needed in order to not only focus on the education, but focus on the community.
Pule completed his 2 years as a TFA core member and chose to continue teaching. He's now in his sixth year at Kamaile. And through TFA, he's also earned a master's degree in education from Johns Hopkins University. As for Furencheck, he completed his 2 year commitment as a TFA core member and remained in the education sector for another 4 years. Today, he continues to support the community he loves, but now as a pediatrician.
teaching itself is an amazing career. It took a lot for me to kind of pivot, because I never said I wanted to leave education, but I was just trying to look for different paths within education.
Fearncheck is a physician with Waianae Coast Comprehensive Health Center, working to bring health services in trailers like this to his beloved Kamaile and other schools in underserved areas.
I'm fortunate enough that I spend clinical time seeing patients 3 days a week, but then the other 2 days a week I get to help. Kamaile is kind of my lead project, trying to bring the services here. I think modern technology is starting to catch up with, you need to look treat a child as a whole child and bring all these services together.
When we come back, how Teach for America is empowering students and their communities with innovation and care.
Our vision is really so that all kids, no matter what their backgrounds are, what zip code they were born or grow up in, all kids have the opportunity to have excellent educational options that lead them to life options.
And the fact that we have a partner like TFA to be there as a support, as a system, and as a support system for the new teachers, it's something that is definitely needed.
Kamaile Academy is a Hawaiian-focused charter school in Waianae, a Teach for America partner with 1,000 students K through 12 and 100 teachers, 17 of them TFA core members or alumni.
It's a critical need, and it's very important that we have, you know, qualified teachers that are in our classrooms in front of our kids to provide great instruction, and TFA has been there for quite a while to fill that void.
But Teach for America is not only filling the void in the classroom. It is finding innovative and creative ways to support the community, its families, their children, and their education.
One thing at Kamaile we really try to do is support the whole child. We want to make sure all of those needs are met.
And that includes clean uniforms for every student. Teach for America secured a Whirlpool grant to provide Kamaile Academy with a washer and dryer for families in need.
So if families need to make sure that kids have clean clothes, then it's here for them to use. But it's open for all of our families that would need that. We want kids to have a strong sense of belonging and feel safe here at the school.
The availability of this on-campus laundry center has resulted in an increase in attendance at Kamaile.
Absenteeism is a real issue here at school. Come to school is important, so we want to do everything we can do to get kids to come to school. So food, clean uniforms, whatever resources we can do to malama.
That's what I really value, is that TFA is not afraid of innovation, TFA is not afraid of creativity, and TFA is not afraid to break down the standard. How do we identify problems in our communities, and how do we support that?
TFA alumna and Kamaile teacher Kamalani Pule Cruz credits Teach for America for keeping her in school and for encouraging her to pursue a college education.
In elementary, it was more about like getting to the next day, getting to the next meal. For me, as a student, college wasn't really something I had considered. College just seemed out of the question, something that I couldn't afford.
But then she met her first TFA teacher at Kamaile, who taught her that anything is possible.
So it's like my teacher's kind of like planted into me, and then here comes sixth grade, and it's like something that I can actually do. The more it became possible or seemed possible, the more I like fought for it, and I wanted it, I craved it.
Cruz started prioritizing academics for the first time.
I took college courses while in high school so that I could knock some prereqs and make college cheaper for me.
And she turned to Fearncheck for guidance with college applications.
He was very much a significant person who helped me get into college. And it's funny because now he's my kid's pediatrician. So it's like full circles.
Or a couple of full circles. With the support of her teachers and community, Cruz is giving back to the next generation as an educator and senior advisor.
It's like seeing them transform into these leaders. And like the part that I played in that is something that makes me very grateful for not only my teachers and like my kumuhula, but also TFA.
Coming up next, how Teach for America instructors from opposite ends of the country are making an impact at a high school in Kona.
most core members come from backgrounds that are not in education, and so there's a diversity of experiences and perspectives that come into the core. And so when you have this mixture of backgrounds and areas of study, it turns into something really beautiful with a lot of innovation and brainstorming.
I think anytime you have new voices, new teachers, new perspectives, people with a lot of energy, people really willing to bring that energy to the classroom, I think it really benefits the classes, it benefits the students as well.
Go and here with motor, and what you're going to have to do, if you imagine that this is going to be your tilt point, do not tilt back here. Tilt around the 40%.
Justin Brown's classroom buzzes with activity as his robotics students work on their projects at Kealakehe High School in Kona.
We should just be testing compression, and if it can shoot out the compression laws. So we just get like some pieces of wood.
But don't even try a version like that.
Brown became a Teach for America Corps member in 2009 with a two-year commitment at Kealakehe.
I came out right out of college. I'd been a jazz musician. I kind of was in the musical world, and I was kind of thinking about policy. The last five generations of my family have been educators, so I had some curiosity about it.
In his first year, the fast-paced, energetic teacher from Texas taught math, created an innovative and popular robotics program, and ran a jazz band.
Constantly on me. Well, Jim, this is the best thing for kids. Come on, come on. I mean, it's just that constant energy level of what are we doing now for kids? How can we help the kids? How can we make it a better environment here at the school?
But I actually think it was less about what I had to offer them and more of what they had to offer me. The better teacher in the classroom, particularly my first few years, was the students, because they were able to kind of bring me into their traditions, the communities, the values, things that they were experts on. So I think it was a lot of the two-way street.
Brown is still going strong, now in his 15th year at Kealakehe, leading about 20 different student activities.
A lot of our TFA teachers, they're really energized. They're really interested in building relationships with students, and they just have a very fresh look at education.
Across campus, Teach for America alumnus Matthew Williams leads a Freshman Foundation's business class. The 2019 Hawaii State Teacher of the Year also teaches creative media and film and broadcast at Kealakehe. Williams is a Kauai native who joined TFA after completing high school and college in Washington State.
I saw that Hawaii was a place that I could possibly be. And I thought, wow, this is a great opportunity, because I was born and raised on Kauai, and then my parents moved to Washington State for education reasons. I also wrote a letter advocating that I be placed in Hawaii.
He was. Williams came home, and he hasn't looked back.
I walk every day into the classroom, like, why does this matter to them? Ultimately, this generation is a reflection of me and what I'm bringing to them, and how do I facilitate opportunities of learning that truly transform their lives and make sure that they can actually live in Hawaii. So they don't, if they don't want to, they don't have to leave, right? For educational reasons or economic reasons.
Williams fulfilled his two-year TFA commitment in Kona and is now in his 12th year in education.
Many of them say, I'm only gonna do this for 2 years and I wanna see what it's like. And then, but many of them stay. They wanna continue because they find out, wow, I really like working with kids. I want to do whatever I can to help kids.
But Teach for America is also about growing and supporting young teachers. In addition to mutual learning in the classroom, Williams says TFA continues to connect him with alumni across the country.
Teach for America is about a network, right? It's about a community. I love when I travel across the country, the one thing that can bring us together, even though you might be from Mississippi and that person might be from California, oh, you're a core member? Oh, what year were you? And like that just instantly just like creates so many different connections.
TFA alumnus and Kealakehe Vice Principal Kevin Argueta never intended to pursue a career in education.
I graduated with a major in international studies. For the longest work, I thought I was going to be working at an embassy. And then one day I learned about Teach for America really just out of nowhere. And I was like, I'm going to apply for that. And I just fell in love with teaching. This is a great organization to get your teaching underway. I got the opportunity to coach fellow teachers, core members, and that work really helped me shape what I wanted to do afterwards, which was support the system in this administrative role.
Still others are using their Teach for America experience to contribute to their communities outside of education.
I'm so grateful that I had that Teach for America experience and really the students who taught me so much, because what I do in my work as a physician is still trying to advance that same mission.
And it gives them a couple of years in the classroom, gives them that perspective in education that a lot of the population doesn't have. And we take that into our other jobs and we use that education and experience to really make a difference where we end up.
Coming up, the far-reaching impact of Teach for America in our communities and what TFA can offer you.
When I was looking at opportunities while I was in college in Massachusetts and wanted to come back home, one of the clearest ways to do that was to join TFA Hawaii.
All right, it was one of the best experiences of my life. But I think the biggest thing that Teach for America did that helped me and supported me throughout my own growth was around training me in diversity and equity and inclusiveness initiatives and how to bring that into my classroom.
Teach for America is not only a program that enables the teachers to grow, it also provides professionals and leaders in our community.
But TFA is contributing on all sides, and it's wonderful to see and wonderful to watch.
Teach for America Hawaii started with a core of just 55 teachers 18 years ago. Since then, at least 920 trained core members and alumni have completed the two-year experience in Hawaii.
And so what we do as Teach for America, what we see our value add is finding and growing the pool of people who are fighting for educational equity. And so we recruit, we train, we support and develop teachers who are first proximate to kids in classrooms, and so they commit a minimum of 2 years to teaching in our most under-resourced schools and communities.
It's an organization that recruits, you know, students and college students that are eager to participate in the education system and I think be a part of a larger movement around equity and justice in education.
It is for both people who are coming out of college and looking what they want to do next. It is also for people who maybe have pursued a career and are looking for a change.
We bring in high intellect, high results oriented college students from here and put them in classrooms in front of more Hawaii kids. And they come with a unique understanding of community when they come home, and it helps not only our local core members, but it helps core members that aren't from Hawaii, because our local core members share knowledge with the others and makes everybody more effective in community.
Today, Teach for America's core members and alumni are directly impacting 95 schools across the state, and 15,700 Hawaii students are experiencing the impact of TFA teachers.
It kind of helped me more. It kind of gave me more like positive energy to like get more reading and like not be lazy and just watch my cell phone.
I think Teach for America does a phenomenal job in bridging that gap. There's something about newly graduated students where there's just so much fire, so much like energy to go out into the world and do something with all that they've learned and what they have to offer.
They're the ones that do the coaching of our sports, they advise clubs, they advise classes. You see them volunteering to tutor after school. Just a burst of energy. I love it. The influence of Teach for America here at Waianae High School has been huge. They filled a gap here at Waianae High School, actually along the whole Leeward Coast, because we're always so short of teachers.
For anyone that cares about their community and wants to find a way to do a sustained act of service. Getting to a classroom is a really great way to understand where there are gaps in social services and where there's opportunities to make systems better.
When I think about my growth as like a professional, I think a lot about how I started, but how I continue to grow. I mean, I couldn't have done all that without Teach for America.
Today, there's a network of about 575 TFA core members and alumni who are currently living and working in Hawaii, teaching and rising to leadership positions in education and other sectors. State Representative and Attorney Scott Matayoshi is one.
Teach for America gave me that experience, gave me those years in the classroom to really know what it was like on the ground teaching kids in a very difficult school. I think it gave me a lot of legitimacy, both in my thinking and in what I said could be done to change education. I think it gave me a lot of ideas on what's actually wrong in the classroom. So when I eventually got into the state legislature, I brought those ideas with me.
Having TFA core members as teachers, coming to that realization, and then ultimately joining the core has completely shifted the trajectory of my life. And is really aligned with, I think, that purpose that I was seeking. To make sure that students have all of the opportunities that they deserve and are, regardless of where they live, where they come from, and how much money they make.
The basic idea is every kid deserves a chance. Every child is the biggest blessing we have, and every child deserves the best opportunity to live out their full potential.
We're looking how to be innovative, how to be adaptable and flexible, and how can we really support the next generation, really.
Isaiah Pule is one of 21 second-generation TFA core members previously taught by TFA Hawaii teachers. In addition to teaching at Kamaile Academy, Pule now serves as executive director of the Ayala Voyaging Academy, still working side-by-side with his former teacher and mentor.
After 2 years of working with Ayala Voyaging Academy, we are now taking actual traction and steps into rebuilding and reestablishing the academy to our community. And I'm working with him, not as a student anymore, but working with him as a colleague, going back full circle, working together on Ayala. I'm very blessed for it.
As Isaiah's been doing his amazing thing, I think a lot of folks have been keeping an eye on him as kind of a breath of fresh air for our community. Proud isn't the word for it. I don't know how to explain how I feel about him kind of being tapped as a part of this rebirth of Ayala and getting it back in the water.
Inspiring the next generation of kids, helping to unleash their passions and talents and strengths to strengthen our community.
Aloha, I'm Ann Botticelli. I'm a proud member of Teach for America Hawaii's Board of Advisors. I'm inspired and encouraged by the profound impact these educators have made in Hawaii over the past 18 years, and I hope you are as well. Mahalo to the companies who helped us tell our story by supporting tonight's broadcast, and to all of the individuals, companies, and organizations who have generously supported TFA Hawaii's efforts for so many years. On behalf of all of us at TFA Hawaii, thank you for watching, and thank you for your support of educational equity.